Hello friends, welcome again. Today we'll solve another problem based on the concept quadratic equation. The question is, a rectangular garden 40 meter by 30 meter is surrounded from outside by a path of equal width. If the area of the path is 456 meter square, find the width of the path. So to solve this problem, we need a diagram. So let us have the diagram. Here, consider quadrilateral A, B, C, D as a rectangular garden whose dimensions are 40 meter and 30 meter. That means the length of this rectangular garden is 40 meter and the breadth of this rectangular garden is 30 meter. So we have written here AB is equal to CD is equal to 40 meter and AD is equal to BC is equal to 30 meter. So here quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle. Now it is given that this garden is surrounded from outside by a path of equal width. So here we don't know the width of that path. So let it be x. That is, the width of path around the garden be x meters. By having this path of width x meter, we have got four quadrilaterals. That is, quadrilateral P, A, B, Q, quadrilateral D, S, R, C, quadrilateral B, O, N, C and quadrilateral L, A, D, M. So as we can see here, all these four quadrilaterals are rectangles. Consider quadrilateral P, A, B, Q. For this one, as it is a rectangle, we can find its area by having the formula length into breadth. For the quadrilateral P, A, B, Q, as it is a rectangle, its length is 40 and the breadth is x. So we have its area length into breadth, that is 40 into x, that's 40x square meter. Similarly, area of quadrilateral DSRC, for this one also the length is 40 as we have proved here and the breadth is x. So its area will be 40x again square meter. Now for quadrilateral BONC again, now this time the length will be 30 meter as BC is equal to 30 meter and the breadth is nothing but the width of the path, that is equal to x. So area of quadrilateral BONC will be equal to L into B, that is 30 into x square meter. Similarly for quadrilateral LADM, which is again a rectangle having length 30 meter and the breadth x meter, so we have its area as area of quadrilateral LADM is equal to length into breadth, that is equal to 30 into x, that is 30x square meter. So we have areas of all these four quadrilaterals. For this rectangular path, we have four squares at four corners with side x meter. So we can find areas of those four squares. For that, first let us find the area of one square. So area of one square is equal to x square square meter, as the formula for area of a square is side square, and four such squares are there. That's why we have to find area, total area of four such squares, that is area of four squares is equal to 4 into x square square meters, because area of one square is x square. That's why area of four square will be 4x square square meter. Now we have to find the total area of the path, and for that we have to add areas of all these four rectangles along with areas of four squares at the corners. That is equal to area of quadrilateral PABQ plus area of quadrilateral DSRC plus area of quadrilateral BONC plus area of quadrilateral LADM plus areas of four squares at corners, that is equal to 4x square. That is, we have just found here. And the total area of the path is given, and it is given to be 456 meter square. So we'll replace here total area of path by 456. That is equal to area of quadrilateral PABQ is 40x plus area of quadrilateral DSRC is also 40x plus area of quadrilateral BONC is 30x plus area of quadrilateral LADM is also 30x plus 4x square as it is. If we go on simplifying, we'll get 456 is equal to 4x square plus 40x plus 40x plus 30x plus 30x. It will be 140x. So getting 456 to the right hand side, we'll get the equation 4x square plus 140x minus 456 is equal to 0, which is the quadratic equation. So we have to solve this quadratic equation. Before that, if we divide this equation by 4, we get x square plus, if we divide 140 by 4, we get 35x minus 456 divided by 4, that's minus 114, that is equal to 0. Now we have to solve this quadratic equation for the variable x. So we have to split minus 114 such that the addition or the subtraction must be plus 35 and the product must be minus 114. So such factors are plus 38 minus 3. So we take the first term x square as it is. We replace plus 35x by plus 38x minus 3x minus 114 is equal to 0. So from the first group, we can take x common. So in bracket, we have x plus 38 minus. From the second group, if we take minus 3 common, we get x plus 38 in bracket, which is equal to 0. So we can take x plus 38 in the first bracket, and in the second bracket, we will have now x minus 3, which is equal to 0. So as the product of these two brackets is 0, that means any one of them must be 0. That is either x plus 38 is equal to 0 or x minus 3 is equal to 0. So go on solving. X plus 38 going to that side, it will become x minus 38, which is not possible because the length of a side cannot be negative. That's why we must have x minus 3 is equal to 0, that is minus 3 going to the right hand side, it will become plus, that is x is equal to 3. So the width of the path is 3 meter, as we have considered the width of the path around the garden is x meter. So we have got here the width of path is 3 meters.